your experience, what project management skills do you think for people who aren't trained in that discipline, which skills do you think that they need the most help with?
So I think the ones that people are usually lacking in the most is going to be either accountability or tracking. And the reason I say accountability or tracking is, again, with the definition of your key performance indicators, when you go into a project, they'll say, okay, they can assign the tasks that need to be done in order to complete the project, but they don't assign who's going to necessarily do them. And that's when stuff falls between the cracks. And it's one of those things where I've been on countless projects. We hit a due date and I was like, okay, so how are we on this? And then I was like, oh, I thought you were doing it. No, I thought you were doing it. Hannah, I thought you had this, right? And so that accountability piece is one that so many people fail to assign. And that's just, I mean, that's through the experiences I've had with teams, that seems to be a big one.
Well, it seems to be right up there with the importance of identifying risks and the plan, outlining the plan,
Yep.
right?
And so with the identifying risks, you also, you know, who's going to prevent or mitigate that risk and how are we going to do it? So before you even plan the work, you know, knowing what those risks are kind of leads into that same piece. So I know I have, you know, my top three risks, and we're always going to identify risks based off of whether or not it has a likelihood to occur, and then what its impact is. So if it has a very high likelihood of occurrence and the impact is minimal, maybe it's something that if we can prevent it, great, but if it occurs, you know, it's quick, we can handle it and move forward. But say it has that high likelihood of occurrence and it has the potential to impact the project for days, weeks, or months, we know we need to include that mitigation in our plan. And we also need to make sure that we've identified who is responsible for that mitigation. And that
Very
I've
good.
had that in the terms of, you know, in construction projects, and a lot of times even for the pharmaceutical world, you know, we go in and we have a project planned out to the day, but we fail to consider that we might not pass an inspection. And you get to the, you know, that inspection, you fail that inspection, and we find out, you know, we had one reason that could have been easily taken care of, but because it wasn't identified, we never tracked whether or not that was going to be completed.